I'm Sharon, and welcome to KG.
Hello, and welcome back to my channel. Today, we're gonna make some rice paper dumplings that's been trending for a while, but we're gonna make them spicy. So spicy rice paper dumplings. It's gonna be so savory, rich in flavor, and it's almost the holiday season now, and it makes a great party food. I've taken some to a potluck gathering a few months back, and it was just amazing. It's all plant-based and loved by everyone. Well, everyone who's into spicy food, I should say. But the level of heat can be totally controlled. And most of all, it's not so complicated for a dumpling. So keep on watching and let's get started. Okay, it's another gluten-free recipe today, if that's what you're looking for. You just have to watch out for a couple of the ingredients today. Which are gochujang, the Korean hot pepper paste, and soy sauce. So for gochujang, I am using the gluten-free option, which is extra spicy as well. So I will put the product information down in the description box below. And for soy sauce, I'm using tamari. You can use any other alternatives that you like. And the rest of the ingredients are simple, just some vegetables, anything you like, but make sure they have lower moisture content. And I'm using cabbage. I'm using the Taiwanese kind, so that's sweeter. Some onions, dry shiitake mushrooms that's been soaked. I'm using extra firm tofu today, and I don't have to press them. And some tangmyeon, the Korean glass noodles, chives, and green onions. If you don't have chives, you can use more of the green onions. And I'm also using the woodier mushrooms for some nice texture. And a generous amount of cooking oil. I am using sunflower oil today. Some Korean hot pepper powder, gochugaru. Garlic and ginger, sesame oil, black pepper, and maybe extra salt later to taste. And of course the rice paper. I'm using 22 by 22 square one, but you can use any shape, any size. And that's it. So to start, we're gonna boil the glass noodles first. Boil for 6 to 7 minutes, according to the instruction in the packaging. And while this boils, we're gonna chop the vegetables. So after 6-7 minutes, when it's done, we just need to strain it. So for the woodier mushroom, we have to check the stem first before we chop them. So for this one, it's pretty clean and it's soft, so we don't have to do anything. But for this one, I don't know if you can see, it's got a little bit of debris and it's kind of hard, so we just have to remove the tip, and then we're just going to sort of slice them like this, make thin slices. So if it's too big, cut in half and then slice it. So basically same with shiitake mushroom that's been soaked. So remove the stem. I like to use the stem for stews, so don't throw them out. So slice first. Give them fine chops like this. You know, you can always put these in a food processor and, you know, chop them up, but I like to hand chop them. So that's it for the mushrooms, and for the rest of the vegetables, it's simple. For the tofu, you can hand crush them or crush with your knife, like so. Just use whatever way you prefer, just crush them. So the glass noodles are ready, so we can give them a rough cut. You can use the knife, but I like to use my scissors, so just rough cut is fine. I like adding glass noodles to mandu or dumplings. because not only do they have good texture, they are fabulous moisture absorbent or flavor absorbent. So it's a really good addition to mandu. So, you know, pan or wok over medium heat, add about a tablespoon of oil. And we'll start with the onions. I'm gonna saute the onion first. You know, if you prefer milder taste of garlic and ginger, you can put them in now. But I prefer them a little bit stronger, so I'm going to add them fresh later to the filling. So when the onion is turning a little translucent, you can put the mushrooms. Two types of mushrooms. Also adding in the chopped cabbage. A little bit of salt and saute for just about a minute, and I'm adding in the tofu. And saute for another minute or two. So we just need to transfer the sauteed vegetables into a mixing bowl, like so. It should be cooled down a little bit first. And then, the glass noodles. Oop. We're going to put everything in now. So, let's start with ginger, garlic. Ginger is a little bit less than 1 teaspoon. I'm adding tamari, this is 2 tablespoons. 1 tablespoon of sesame oil. Gochujang, the Korean hot pepper paste. This is 2 tablespoons. Gochugaru is optional. And another optional ingredient for the heat is the chili pepper. I skipped it because my gochujang is already spicy. Put in the black pepper. Green onion. And chives. Because I added onions and cabbage, I get the sweetness from them. But if you don't find it sweet enough, you can add about a teaspoon of sugar. Now we can have a taste. Unlike meat fillings, this is tasteable before cooking. Oh wow, this is so good. This is perfect for me. But if you find it not salty enough, you know, you can add more salt. If too salty, you can add more tofu, you know. So we're now ready to make some dumplings. So I'm using my pizza pan once again, just like in my vegan sundae video. And adding some room temperature or slightly cold water. You can't use warm water for this recipe. Because we don't want it to be too soft. So soak it for no more than 6 seconds, I would say. Then put 2 tablespoons of the filling and we're going to fold it the rice paper just needs to be flexible enough to be able to fold it. Otherwise, it's gonna be so easy to rip or break when you fry it later. And you might be tempted to just finish it right here, but we need to double wrap it. And trust me, we need double wrapping because it's so easy to rip while you fry them. Just make sure it's not too wet because if it's too wet, it's not going to be as crispy. It's going to bubble while it fries and pops, and that's when the disaster happens. Try the small size and the round one. Just one tablespoon. So if you have leftover filling, don't worry, you can keep in the fridge for up to about a week, and you don't have to make just the dumplings. Of course, you can make another batch, but it's good as like bibimbap topping or like a sandwich filling. So it's got lots of uses. So there you go. And I find that the small wrappers are thinner, so they're stickier, and when you make them, make sure to space them out so they don't stick to each other. And I find that air drying them slightly helps with the crispiness later when we pan fry them, so we'll give it a few minutes. So on a pan over medium to medium high heat, put generous amount of oil, and we're gonna place our rice dumpling. Make sure not to overcrowd them, not to touch each other. Otherwise, they're going to stick to each other. Make sure the temperature is not too high, but not too low either. So that's it.
So there you have spicy rice paper dumpling, or 매운 rice paper mandu ready. It's all plant-based, of course, and it's perfectly crispy outside, and it's chewy as you bite into it, and you get this burst of flavor with heat as you enjoy that bite. And I gotta admit that mandu or dumplings are not the easiest dish to create because it involves a lot of work, but having the rice paper as the wrapper makes the work so much easier because you don't need to pleat and you don't have to worry about how it looks. I mean, it looks great as is, right? And it tastes marvelous. And it's so full of flavor that you don't necessarily have to have the dipping sauce, but if you still prefer to have one, you can just have a simple one with some soy sauce, with a little bit of lemon juice or vinegar, and that should be good. So this is spicy rice paper dumpling. I hope you enjoyed my recipe today. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again next time. Bye!